With the benefit of 2020 hindsight on the 20th anniversary of the trade that undid the Montreal Canadiens, think about this. Maybe none of this happens if there had been a simple piece of plexiglass in the forum.
He's wrapped up, able to get loose now. Kozlov, yes. Score!
Patrick Roy with the arms up in the air so I can't see it.
Patrick Roy was in a foul mood on December 2nd, 1995. The visiting Red Wings had turned his net into Montreal's red light district, and coach Mario Tremblay was in no rush to spare his star goalie the humiliation.
He did! He finished!
Yes,
score!
Indeed! Oh, my God, look out.
Matthew Gandino!
He's gonna go nuts.
With Detroit leading 8-1 in the second period, Waugh greeted mock cheers for a routine save with a sarcastic salute.
Waugh, the save gets the
shot. Oh, baby, look at
him.
Got the hands up in the air.
After a ninth goal, Wall was excused for the night.
Here comes a hook. Have mercy on me.
The goalie walked by his coach as they wordlessly exchanged murderous glances and doubled back to Ronald Corey, the Canadiens' president, who sat directly behind the bench. With no plexiglass, with nothing to impede the livid Wall from blurting the first thing on his mind, he told Corey, it's my last game in Montreal.
Maybe I could have tell him to come at the bench after the 7 goals, maybe. But, you know, I don't think it's 2 goals who's gonna change a career.
And so, like a Rube Goldberg contraption, where one bit of lunacy inexorably leads to another, an off night ended 4 days later with a disastrous trade that roiled the Canadiens for years.
It's not easy, and it's too bad how this whole situation came out.
If Serge Savard had still been general manager, he likely would have put a stop to all the silliness. Savard's default position always was, take a deep breath. But Corey had fired him and coach Jacques Demers 7 weeks earlier. In their places were GM Réjean Houle, who had been an executive at Molson Brewery and was now doggy paddling in the deep end, and Tremblay, who had been a TV analyst, but never a coach. Colorado GM Pierre Lacroix, who had been trying to pry the goalie away when the franchise was in Quebec, pounced on the laughably green Bleu-Blanc-Rouge brain trust, acquiring the two-time Conn Smythe winner and Canadiens captain Mike Keane for Jocelyn Thibault, Martin Rutchinski, and Andre Kovalenko. In relative terms, Uhl traded a franchise legend in mid-career for a bag of pucks and a used Zamboni.
From the Canadian standpoint, I don't think this is a very good trade.
I flew with Waugh to Colorado after his farewell press conference in Montreal. In downtown Denver, a howdy neighbor kind of taxi driver asked his passengers where they were from. Montreal, I said. Hey, we got a new goalie from there, the cabbie said. Know anything about him? Waugh was the one who answered. Well, I hope he's a good guy.
Colorado, Stanley Cup champions.
7 months later, Waugh would win his third Stanley Cup. He would add another cup and Conn Smythe with the Avalanche in 2001 and hold the NHL record for career wins when he retired in 2003. Yes, in the net, he was a good guy.